有一个人哦，伊是不只有钱人，伊要死以前，伊就留落伊的遗产和伊的子女。
There was once a very rich man. As he was dying, he left his properties, material things, to his children. His father has a lot of cows. He has 17 cows. May that 17 cows is not a lot. May I ask you, how many cows do you have? Maybe you don't have any. He had three children. He left his cows to his children. So when he died, his children brought out his last will and testament. The will said, goes like this. I have 17 cows. The oldest son, because you're the oldest, I will leave you half of my cows. Second son, I will leave you one third of my cows. The third son, you're the youngest, I will leave you one ninth of my cows. The three children were scratching their head, how can you divide the 17 cows by two? By three and by nine. Because they don't want to kill the cow and divide the cow because if the cow is dead, it's less value. There are many people who are good in math, maybe you have already found the solution. But because of this, because of inheritance, they are starting to fight about this. In the end, they couldn't find a solution, so they went to the wise person in the town. So this wise man was scratching his head and listening to this story from the children. So in the end, he said, okay, he asked his worker to bring one of his cows there. And he added his cow to the 17 cows. And he started reading the will again. The first son, he gets half of the cows. 18 divided by 2, how many?
9只, 所以就退9只去了, 9只退去.
9 cows, so they take away the 9 cows, gave it to the oldest son. Second son gets one third. One third of 18 is how many?
3只. 6只, 对,
6只. Six cows, yes.
所以就退2、4、6只去.
They took away the 6 cows to give to the second son.
第三件9分之一几只?
The third son, one ninth, how many cows?
2只, 就退2只去.
So he gets the 2 cows.
剩几只?
How many cows left?
Oh, 还剩一只.
There's 1 cow left.
所以那个智慧的人就可以对一只再退去了.
So the wise man says, okay, I'll take back my cow.
大致解决.
Solved.
I don't
know if you have understand this, how can this be?
但是让我们看到说,
but it shows us that if you want to solve these kinds of problems, you need more IQ.
什么是 IQ?
What is IQ?
IQ is intelligence, 看你多少智慧, 是不是?
That shows how much wisdom you have.
有的人比较多,
some may have more, some may have less.
IQ 较低，还是 IQ 较高？Maybe
have higher IQ or lower IQ.
但是现在人我真侪讲 IQ 重要，但是可能 EQ 更加重要。
Some people say IQ is very important, but what's more important is EQ.
EQ 是感情 emotional quotient.
EQ is emotional quotient.
因为现在人咱都咱人际关系 connectedness， 咱真正。
Because the world is so connected, it's so important to know how to deal with relationships.
So emotional quotient 更加重要.
So that's more important, emotional quotient.
但是在箴言里面，让人看到另外一款的智慧，可能是第一重要.
But the book of Proverbs show us maybe another kind of intelligence, which is the most important.
SQ. SQ is spiritual 属灵的 quotient.
That's spiritual quotient.
因为你若敬畏神。
Because if you fear the Lord, if you know your Creator, if you know where you are from, and you know why you were created, how you live your life will be very different. So maybe what's most important is spiritual quotient. This morning we'll continue our study on the book of Proverbs. From the book of Proverbs, we will learn how to gain wisdom. And this morning we'll be talking about when you refuse to listen to wisdom, when you refuse to gain wisdom, what's the result? First point, the wisdom is available to everyone. We'll be reading Proverbs chapter
1:20-23.
And we'll start looking at the first few verses.
Verses 20-23.
Out in the open, wisdom calls aloud. She raises her voice in the public square. On top of the wall, she cries out. At the city gate, she makes her speech. How long will you who are simple love your simple ways? How long will mockers delight in mockery and fools hate knowledge? Repent at my rebuke. Then I will pour out my thoughts to you. I will make known to you my teachings. Here, wisdom is portrayed as a woman. What is she doing? Here we see that she's calling loudly. She was out in the open. She was in the public square and she was shouting from top of the wall. We know that during the ancient times, the city gate, the place there is very important. Because everything happens by the city gate.
They
buy and sell there. They go to the judge near at the city gate. Their leaders were there sitting by the city gate. In fact, everything when you want to court to any transaction, you do it near by the city gate.
So
here it is saying that that wisdom is shouting by the city gate, by the public square. To show us that you can hear, everybody can hear from the wisdom. Wisdom is not something that you whisper, I'll tell you, and I don't tell anybody else. Wisdom is not only only a few people can hear about. But wisdom is given and is so that everybody can hear about it. By the city gate, by the city wall, when she shouts, everybody will hear. It reminds me of James chapter
1 verse 5.
If anyone lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all who without finding fault, and it will be given to you.
It's
very clear. If you lack wisdom, you ask for it and it will be given. You ask for it and God will give it to you. But when you ask for it, you note one thing. Because when you ask for what you ask for, it's what you ask for wisdom. If you ask for money, it's very simple, they just give you money. When you ask for wisdom, what is wisdom? Let's not forget wisdom, our skills for living daily life. So when you ask for wisdom, wisdom is not just showered down from heaven. Wisdom is not something you can eat. When you eat it, you will gain wisdom.
So
how do you gain wisdom? When you ask for wisdom from the Lord, how will He give it to you? Wisdom is something that you have to live out. You have to do it so that you can gain it. You have to experience it so that you can gain wisdom. I don't know if you ever asked for patience.
你若求吞吞哦, 主就会给你吞吞。
If you ask for patience, yes, the Lord will give you patience.
也给你很多机会让我吞吞。
He will give you a lot of opportunities to learn patience.
哇，那个求吞吞哦, 车不知道看到头前那车偏偏真正慢。
That day I asked for wisdom, I don't know why, but that car in front of me was driving so slowly.
哎呀，你看手机的囡仔就偏偏。
Your wife, your children were just taking up all the time in the restroom. They will not come out. You ask for wisdom, yes, the Lord will give you plenty of opportunities to learn wisdom. If you ask for love, then the Lord will give you a lot of people to love, those unlovable people. You ask for forgiveness, you ask the Lord to help you to learn forgiveness. How do you forgive a person? A person has to have done something that you need to forgive. Nobody has hurt me. Why would I need to forgive someone? For you to learn forgiveness, yes, the Lord will give you plenty of opportunities to get hurt. But something that's very clear, everyone can gain wisdom. The question is whether you are willing to go through it, to learn it. But I'm not saying that it is easy to learn wisdom. Wisdom, it's open, it's something that everybody can gain. But the second point, that's the question. Because wisdom is not something that everyone wants. Because some people does not like to gain wisdom, does not want wisdom. Let's look at 24-25.
而且伊讲我何法恁却唔肯听叹，我曾求无人理会，还多等天气我一切诶困戒，唔肯受我诶责备。
But since you refuse to listen when I call and no one pays attention when I stretch out my hand, since you disregard all my advice and do not accept my rebuke.
经常咱智慧哦，其实是底下咯。
Many times the wisdom is right there in front of us. If you want to know whether you can do this or not, in fact, there's something that many people, everybody already knows. The question is not whether we can gain wisdom or not. But the question is because we refuse to do what wisdom dictates. Wisdom is right there. But we want to do things our own way. Like just like a person, he went to a psychiatrist. He said, Doc, can you help me? He says, I'm having an affair, I have a mistress, and because of this, my conscience is killing me. Can you help me? The psychiatrist says, yes, of course I can because I help you, these kinds of people. And the doctor says, are you asking me to help you how to end this affair? But he says, no, I want you to help me to end this conscience. He knows what is right, but he still wants to continue doing what is wrong. And that is true, but that is also often our problem. But the problem is we know what is right, but we still want to do what is wrong, what we want to do.
Have
you ever seen a donut that is covered with chocolate, something that is so delicious that you want to eat?
Bavarian cream.
That donut has Bavarian cream filling. It's something that's so good. And you want a double cream, double sugar cup of coffee.
At
the back of your mind, the voice is saying, no, you should not eat that. Aren't you on a diet? Don't you know that sugar is very bad for your body? But you still eat that donut.
You
know it's bad for you, but because you want to eat it, you still eat that donut.
有一个人说,
yes, like a man is complaining that that cheesecake in the refrigerator was bothering him, was tempting him.
That cheesecake
was so soft, so creamy, something so delicious.
That
the entire afternoon, that cheesecake was tempting me.
我要,
and in the end, he said, no, I want to fix this problem.
So
he solved that problem. How did he solve that problem?
He ate
that cheesecake so that there's be no more temptation.
Oftentimes, you
know the problem, what the problem is, but we still want to do things that is wrong.
Let us note verse
24.
Look
at verse 24. You refuse to listen when I call, and no one pays attention when I stretch out my hand. Here you're seeing that he's not saying that the person does not understand, but the person understands but refuses to listen.
It's not that
he could not hear, could not understand, but he refuses to listen.
我所愿意的善,我还多得没的罪,我不愿意的恶,我都去做。
Paul in Romans chapter 7 verse 19 says, for I do not do the good I want to do, but the evil I do not want to do, this I keep on doing.
当我们做,我们知道不应该做,我们却强强去做。
If we do what we know we should not be doing, but we still continue doing it,
我们明知不对,我们却去做。
We know it is wrong, but we still do it.
什么事情发生?
What happens?
咱来看，搁刷落去，两节甲咱讲。伊讲，入六节咯。伊讲，恁拄着灾厄，我就发笑；惊遐临到恁，我就的确啼笑；惊遐临到恁，好亲像强风灾难来到，亲像暴风急难痛苦临到，伫恁的身上。
At verses 26 to 29, I in turn will laugh when disaster strikes you. I will mock when calamity overtakes you. When calamity overtakes you like a storm, when disaster sweeps over you like a whirlwind, when distress and trouble overwhelm you.
当你明知是唔对，又愿要去做。
When you still continue doing what you know is wrong, what would happen?
You get what you ask for. 你若真是要你行，你就是推着你该得的后果。
Verses are telling us that you will get what you ask for. You will get the consequences of your action.
This
is not talking about forgiveness. If you've done something wrong and you ask the Lord for forgiveness, yes, the Lord will forgive you.
This
is not talking about forgiveness.
This is
not talking about forgiveness. This is talking about the consequences of the wrong that you have done. If you still insist on doing what is wrong, you will receive the consequences, the natural consequences of the wrong, the actions that you're doing.
You ask for it,
This saying is very clear. You're asking for it. You know it is wrong, you know what will happen, but you still insist on doing it, then you're asking for those consequences. Maybe what's a bigger problem is, how can you win over this? First point, the wisdom is available to everyone. And second point says, not everyone wants wisdom. How do we solve this problem then? How do I do what is right and stop doing what is wrong? I hope this third point will help us. Wisdom is something you need to have before you need it. Before you need it, you need to have it already. From
28 to 23. 唔听我的劝诫，藐视我一切的责备，所以就的确吃自洁的果子，充满自洁的果苗。
Verses 28-31. Then they will know; they will call to me, but I will not answer. They will look for me, but will not find me, since they hated knowledge and did not choose to fear the Lord. Since they would not accept my advice and spurned my rebuke, they will eat the fruit of their ways and be filled with the fruit of their schemes.
最后，伊讲，然后啊，说 then， 然后，你若拄着问题，我袂听。
And here he started with the word then. That means, if you do this, then I will not listen.
然后廿九章再跟人讲，因为干哪，伊讲干哪，只我那唔听，因为恁开始就唔听我讲嘞。
In verses 29 and 30, he gives the reason why he will refuse to listen to us, because you did not want to listen to me in the first place.
伊讲主干咩安尼嘛？
You might say, will the Lord do that?
哦，伊敢真是唔听我的祈祷吗？
Will he refuse to answer and listen to my prayers?
咱阁看一条经文。
Let's look at another verse in the Bible.
咱看这个撒加利亚七章十三节。
Let's look at Zechariah 7:13.
万军的耶和华安尼讲，伊讲我不呼叫因，因唔听；当因呼求我，我也唔听。
The Lord said, as I called, they will not hear; so they called, and I will not hear.
圣经的话。
This is the words in the Bible.
意思是讲，咱啊一直唔听，一直唔听，一直唔听，到咱对着问题哦，你才要来求，主嘛是唔听的。
This is saying that if we keep on refusing to listen to the Lord when we encounter problems and we come to the Lord, He will refuse to listen to us.
咱啊明知这个是唔对，却一直去做，拄着问题，主讲我家己讲你都唔听，所以你若讲我也是唔听。
If we know that this is wrong, but we still insist on doing it, then when we come to the Lord with the consequences, the Lord said, "Because you refuse to listen to me, I won't listen to you also."
所以重要的是，咱啊听到的时阵，咱就随随去。
So what is most important when we hear, we need to learn to obey.
是不是今天主继续在跟你讲这样的事情？
Is the Lord telling you something again today?
几礼拜前咱已经有讲到了。
A few weeks ago, we've already talked about this.
我不知道圣灵在感动你，在刺激你的心，什么事在刺激你的心？
I don't know what the Spirit is speaking to you, what the Spirit is convicting you.
但是主若一摆又一摆在提醒咱，
but if the Lord is reminding us again and again,
咱却唔听，
and we refuse to listen,
安尼真自然到落尾，咱就拄着咱该得的后果。
Then naturally we will experience the consequences of our actions.
所以咱今仔日有法的时阵，咱今仔日就听。
So today, while there is still opportunity, let's start listening.
因为哦，那到迄个到代志发生，你才要决定，其实已经太晚了。
Because when you wait until that thing happened before you make your decision, it's already too late.
Time of decision, 你这边决定哦，袂赴了。
If at the time of decision, that's when you will decide, then it's already too late.
In 去研究哦，伊讲人哦，咱真自然是，咱是 creatures of habit， 是咱的动作哦，是和咱的习惯来定。
There's a study that saying that man is a creature of habit. That means we are always determined by the habits that we make.
咱一日真侪决定哦，是咱的习惯帮助咱决定。
Many decisions that we make throughout the day are made by our habits.
比如说哦，即阵咱有位人翘脚。
For example, like right now, some of us are crossing our legs.
你翘刚翘吧，还是哎，对哦，我那翘脚嘞。
Did you consciously make the decision to cross your leg, or you just see oh?I just crossed my leg.
啊，那位有人的手安尼，有人的手安尼，有的手唔得得咯。哎，你跳过伊吧，你无注意哦。哎，对啊，我的手那安尼啊。
Some are crossing their arm or touching their head. You might not be conscious that you're already doing that.
这是咱的习惯。
These are our habits.
啊，真侪人话讲牧师啊，你稳固啦，愈来愈稳固咯。
Some people are saying, 牧师, you're slouching. You're it's getting worse.
我无跳钢要稳固是，对啊，无注意就稳固，因为是习惯。
I'm not doing it on purpose. Maybe I'm doing it out of habit.
咱真侪决定是习惯的时阵，咱就是安尼决定了。
Many of our decisions are made by and determined by our habits.
所以你无需要决定以前，你都需要有智慧。要决定的时，你才知影要怎样决定。
Before the time of decision comes, you need to have wisdom, so that by the time of decision, you need to make the decision, you will know how to make that decision.
代志未到以前，你都需要有智慧了。
Before something happens, you need to have wisdom already.
就养成一款的习惯。
It has to become a habit already.
到问题来，你知影要怎样反应。
So when problem comes, you know how to respond. If the time for battle is already come, it's too late to start learning how to fire a gun. If at the morning of your appointment with the dentist, that's when you start brushing your teeth 10 times, it's all too late. There's a Chinese saying with the time that you're thirsty already, that's when you start to dig for a well, it's too late.
我有一个我好的俗语就是到腹肚疼了你这边压坑不会好了
And I have another proverb which I formulated myself. If your tummy is already queasy, it's too late to start digging a hole. If you have a stomach ache, it's too late already to start digging for a hole. Before that thing happens, before you need to make that decision, you need to have already the right habits. How do you win over? How do you overcome temptations? You need to have good spiritual habits. Good spiritual habits, something that you develop every day. It's not when you wait for big problems to come when you start developing these good habits. It's something you need to do every day. Every day you read the Bible. Every day you pray. Every day you learn to obey. If you learn to develop these habits, when big problems come, then you know how to make the right decisions. If you have these good habits you develop every day, many problems will not even come.
譬如说,你的车,你定定有在去照顾,定定有maintain好些。
For example, you maintain your car well every day.
And it
will be seldom that you encounter problems like your car breaking down in the middle of the
road.
If you develop the habit of patience, then you would have less arguments, less fights with other
people.
If you have the habit of kindness, then you would have good and develop peaceful relationships.
The
habit of goodness will prevent evil.
So
right now, today is our chance to learn wisdom. Before problems come, we need to learn wisdom. So let me ask you, how are your spiritual habits? Do you regularly train your spiritual life, your spiritual body? Don't wait for big problems to come. Don't wait for big decisions to be made before you start developing these habits. So I hope that this morning, let's learn to seek wisdom. Because wisdom is something that we can all gain. But oftentimes you refuse to listen to wisdom. Don't forget, before you encounter problems, we need to have gained wisdom. Let me end this time with a story. You know, in the North Pole, how the Eskimos would kill a wolf. Wolves are scary creatures. To hunt for wolves, it's very difficult, very dangerous. So the Eskimos, they found a way to easily kill a wolf. They would get a knife, they would sharpen the knife. And they would dip the knife, they would soak it with the blood of a seal. And they would let it freeze. And they will dip it again in the blood and they will let it freeze again. Until they would have made a popsicle stick, that's like something that we eat in an ice cream. And they would leave it outside. The wolves have very keen sense of smell. And they would easily smell the blood of the seal. And they would see that frozen delight and they would start licking this. When they lick it, they would really love it because they've tasted blood. And they would keep on licking until they have licked all the blood, and eventually they will just be the knife. And that knife would cut their tongue. But because of the cold that they've been licking, it will have numbed their tongue, and the wolf will not feel the pain.
So in
And the more they lick, they would have tasted fresh blood. And they would even be more excited and to lick even further and faster. Eventually, they will collapse from the blood lost. Because they would be licking their own blood. Eventually, because of blood loss, they will die. In your life, do you have this kind of bloody knife?
It's
a knife that you when you lick and you would taste it and you would enjoy it more and you keep on licking. You would think that, oh, there's no harm. It's not harming others. It's not harming myself. You may not know. But the more you lick that knife, the more you will be harming yourself. You may say that this wolf is so stupid, but maybe we're even more foolish than this wolf. Because the wolf does not know, it's ignorant, it doesn't know it would harm itself. But we know. It's very obvious we have wisdom, we can understand. But if we keep on doing it, and we are just asking for it, we know, but we keep on doing that. So if the Lord is speaking to you this morning, I hope that you would learn to listen and stop. And turn
360
degrees, turn back to the Lord. Sorry, just 180 degrees. And turn back to the Lord. And gain true freedom in the Lord. And you can gain wisdom from God.
Let's pray. So, 祝我这个信息无过接受，因为阮无爱听，阮唔倾听。愿你的灵继续对阮讲话，互阮真正有智慧。今仔日既然听到讲智慧，阮大家拢知，阮拢有咯。但是阮有时阵，阮唔倾听，阮也唔倾听，有一日灾难来到，你也是唔听，因为阮受经过的时阵，阮唔听。主啊，这个信息无过接受，因为阮无爱听，阮唔倾听。愿你的灵继续责备阮，鼓励阮，继续对阮讲话，互阮会愿意来听，唔着爱阮无搁做，着爱阮应该着学习的，阮值得学习去做。接着，阮再有真多，我当真多真正有智慧的人，真多你的兄弟，多荣耀，互你的名，愿你继续对阮讲话，祈祷奉主耶稣基督圣名所求的。